BMW first launched the S1000RR in 2008 to compete in WSBK, and then released as a production model to the public in 2010. That year, it demolished the competition, easily winning our 10 Best Superbike of the Year. Since then, it's seen only minor updates, this last year seeing changes to the emissions for Euro 4 standards and electronics added a standard. But besides that, things like the motor and chassis have remained unchanged. Despite being a little long in the tooth, though not as long as the Honda and Suzuki were until this year, the BMW has remained a favorite amongst riders everywhere. California Superbike School uses them for their schools with great success. They still do well every year at the Isle of Man TT, and we still get hounded every time we leave them out of a story by people who've experienced them and love them. The fact of the matter is, we think there are other and better superbikes on the market. At least for now. These spy shots show a pretty radical jump for the Bavarian brand. The whole package looks even more svelte than before. Something that the original S1000RR was praised for when first unveiled. The engine is all new, down to the clutch covers, cases, and cylinder heads, and the cylinders appear slightly more vertical, which could allow the motor to be moved forward slightly in the frame.